Okay, she send a pics of me before they hit the gram. All night we run them numbers on a fitness app. This a cricket match, couple day affair with your wife. You think she leaving with my hoodie, told her give it back. Stop off at the hometown looking like...
Right guys, welcome to Living Large, a new YouTube series which is going to take place over the next 15 to 18 months. So we're taking you guys along with us on this journey. And as we said, we're living large, training, bodybuilding, lifestyle. It's all under one roof under this series. So welcome to the new series. And today is the first episode, so we're super, super gassed. We got the man, the magic man, Dan Take Your Shot Williams, who is filming everything as always, guys. So if you're ever in need, make sure you always shout him out for any type of visual content. All of ours is done by the man. There's so much going on in this series, guys. There's so much going to be going on in this episode. All I got you guys to do is literally comment and let me know what you guys want to see. The specifics with lifestyle, with fitness, with, you know, relationship, whatever it may be, guys. Just get commenting and get involved with this whole series. We'll go into as much detail as possible. There'll be nothing unseen. And it's going to be fucking exciting. So, yeah, big leg day. Let's go smash it.
No, Giggs was class.
I grew up watching him, so I know this pain.
Yeah, it was the wrong Giggs, bro. You just said he had no skills.
I don't rate him as a skilled player.
Who's a better left winger?
If you think Salah's better, that's all good, but you just can't say he's got no skill.
Tell me another left winger better than Giggs in the Premiership.
Back in the day?
Anytime, I can't think of anyone. Tell me one.
Or just because he won 13 years.
All right, tell me another left winger better than Giggs.
Salah.
Other than Salah?
Forget Salah. One dead player you've got,
you know. I'm stuck here, you know. Football ain't my thing. Who's better than Giggs?
Yeah, we know that. Not that
body. No, man. I can't think of another left winger better than
Blitz. Salah's just coming with the key.
No, Salah's levels and Salah's better. Cool. Like, you can't.
4 years in a row.
That's a conversation we have, but you can't write Giggs
up. He's not shit, but Salah's better than him.
You said he had no skills.
I know he's got no skills. I'll stick by that, you know. Nah, I rate Eric.
Why?
Because he fly kicked the guy in the stands.
Oh, there you go.
That's what you rate. That was sick, boy.
When he scored that goal and he put his collar up like you're on the gun, you're the old shit.
So your classification of a bad boy player is because he fly kicked man and he put his collars up. Nothing to do football.
Nah, the captain was a good player, bro.
But nah, he was head and shoulders above everyone. But you know, Liverpool, the best team in the whole of the world, so. That's true, you know, Liverpool.
My actual argument was that Salah's better than Giggs, but I can't, because I like Giggs, I can't say he's still one of the best left.
And yesterday I was stuck.
No, I've heard that's
because I grew up watching Giggs and it's not shit, yeah, but it's hard to pick like between them two.
Troy, it's your series, you got the final say.
Yeah.
Salah or Giggs?
Giggs is a bad man, bro.
Giggs all the way?
Yeah, Giggs, man. I don't know who Salah is. Joe said, over the next 5 weeks, I want to start to build your top line. So when I say top line, I mean hitting your side chest, the line going across here, so more delts, a bit more top chest, a bit more delts, simple as that. So we've got three uppers and two lowers. So today's lower, like I said, they're still hardcore fucking leg sessions. So I'm classing it as a top line and leg focus split. So first exercise, four. Line hamstring curls. Remember, on week one, we started off with three sets. We had an additional set at week three, so that's four working sets on there. Now we've got hip extension, which is kickbacks. So hammy and glutes is something we need to work on as well. So second exercise is that. We've got 50 reps on this, which is a giant set. So kind of like a rest pause, which a lot of you might know what a rest pause is. You basically work till failure, rest for 10 seconds, and go back in. So on a 50 rep set, I'm probably aiming for around 20 to 30 reps before having a rest. Trying to work close as failure as possible, maybe two reps in reserve, and then getting the additional whatever it takes to get up to 50, if that makes sense. So 50 reps in total, two rests are allowed, but that's all. So kind of brutal for the glutes.
The hometown looking like I'm still the man. I see some epitomes of what it's like to finish last. I wonder what it's like to drop and ain't feeling that. Been through a lot, but I ain't never feel
sad. What
the fuck is that? Well, six rests.
Actually, I got 30, 15. Got it.
Yeah, check the body count, but I ain't saving bones. This a favorite song, what's I going later, folks? Circle staying close, strangers taking notes, so we stay at home. Traps, I'ma call me cooking at the crib, y'all to set the boss a lower guy.
So this is our leg session today. Leg curl, hip extension, hack squat, leg extension lunges, calf raises. That's week one. How many sets we got? Week two, week three, which is what we're currently on. So as you can see, certain exercises increase by a set, which obviously increases volume over the course of the week as well. So we've got four sets, which is a one additional set, an extra five reps on our giant set, an extra set on our hack squat, and an extra set on our superset of leg extension and lunges. So as you can see, pretty much horrible, but that's what I was trying to explain to you guys a little bit earlier. This training plan is obviously specific for what we're trying to do, what we're trying to build on over a specific period of time. And rather than just focusing on training heavy, it's actually the first time where we've never worked till failure. So coming up to the final week of the mesocycle, it'll be interesting to actually see how far we can push it to failure, because like I said, the last couple of weeks we've always been working in either three reps in reserve, which means three reps before failure, or two reps before failure. So different way of training, which I'm sure most of you guys are used to us training literally till failure, but it's working and it's more for long term, less risk of injury, which is something we want to build on if we want to have a long term career in bodybuilding. And that's something that you've got to advise to clients and anyone who wants a career in bodybuilding. You've got to think long term. So week three of this program is going well, but like I said, we've got an additional four or five sets today, so it's going to be horrible. Also today we've got Theo, who is just about alive. See how all the roles are reversed? What's it called? Roles reversed. Yeah, so obviously we had me prep, me dying. Scott's prep, Scott dying. Theo's prep, Theo's dying. So there's always someone to support each other in this whole process and this team. So that's what works well. We've got Scott, who's on the back end of his prep now, coming into the off-season phase, which is going to be fucking epic. And now it's time to push Theo through the last couple of days of his prep now. He actually booked a show for 4 weeks. He's competing in Denmark, but we found out 2 days ago that he's got to do a qualifier in 10 days. So, you know, spanner in the works, but it's going to work in our favour because he's going to come in fucking diced. I heard that you got pressed, started telling names. You obsessing over hoes, she replied, I let her wait. Had to grow up at the tender age of 10 and change. So glad it's something I don't do that never been the same. The same. Swear to God, I ain't been the same. Oh, judging from previous experience of injuries, I'm going to give this last set a rest today.
That's what I did on the pendulum.
Yeah.
About a week out. I did the same thing on the pendulum. It was about a week out from the qualifiers. Everything felt good. Got through the sets.
Yeah.
Exactly the same place, same feeling. I felt it on the way down. I went for the second one and found a little pop and I just left it. And I just left it there. Got a sports massage. It wasn't a tear or anything, but just a slight pull. But if I would have gone for that next rep, God knows why, it could escalate very easily to a tear. So you've got to be sensible with these things. You've got three good working sets. It's about longevity more than anything. So just forget about that last set, we'll move on, we've done enough. But safety first.
Yeah.
Leave that there.
So about a little tweak on my quad on the last set of that hack squat. So the next two exercises after this are extensions and lunges superset. So I just tried them both quite light, but like I said, I'm not at a point now where I'm willing to risk anything for an extra set. Like, ego's left at the door and everything right now. So I tried a little light set, can still feel a little tweak. And like I said, judging from previous injuries, I kind of know what to expect. When you feel a little ping or a little pull, I think that's your key point just to leave an exercise. When I've done my chest, it was a little pull and I carried on with the movement and you just felt a ripping sensation. So I'm not willing to do that in my quad. Imagine that to a fucking first start to the episode of the series. First to my quad. Nah, it's not happening. So gonna rest from then. I'll speak to Joe and see what we can add in. But like I said, as you progress through bodybuilding, you put yourself at risk of injury all the time because of how hard and how intense you're training. So that comes to another point and how much you're going to put into everything around it, not just your training and diet, your recovery, your sleep, supplementation, you know, things like sports massages, you know, things just like that are going to be so important. Warming up and cooling down correctly, I know you might think it's basic and stupid, but as we get older and as we build our knowledge on things, sometimes we do seem to forget the little principles which are most important. So we'll reset, we've got a rest day tomorrow, then upper on Saturday, so it gives my legs about 4 or 5 days recovery. So I'll get some deep tissue massages over the weekend, have a little rest, reset and go from there. But I'm going to leave the extensions and lunges for now. Like I said, I know my capability, I know my body quite well. So we're going to finish up on calf raises. We're going to go through some rounds with Theo. You lot can see how fucking sick Theo's looking, because I think the last time you guys seen him was in one of Scott's bigger and better last episode. So like I said, we've booked a show and he's got to do a qualifier 10 days early now. So imagine being 4 weeks out and you're told you've got to do a show in 10 days to qualify for that show. So speed prep volume 3. I done it, Scott done it, now it's Theo's fucking turn to do it. So we're going to go through some rounds with Theo. And then we'll wrap things up at home, I think.
You guys know the routine, this is the spot. 2 weeks ago it was me there, a couple of weeks before that it was Troy there, so it's good because this is how we work. I put an Instagram post up the other day and it's like we literally passed the baton, how Americans say it, passed the baton, Troy to me, now it's me to Theo. And the good thing is we've all been in this situation. Every point of bodybuilding that we're all at now, because we're all in 3 different places. I'm in a recovery post-show phase. Troy's, you know, into his off-season, a good amount. Theo's 10 days out. We've all been in these scenarios at the same times that we are now, if that makes sense. So rewind a couple of weeks back. Troy's in his recovery phase. I'm deep in prep. Theo's at the start of prep, feeling fresh. So we can all relate to each other. So when Theo's there dying, I've literally just been there. So I know my job here now is just to put him through it, not to chat shit, not to ask him if he's okay, just make him get the work done and send him home. Troy's doing exactly the same. Now that I'm back equally, I can push Troy because Troy's been running everything, and then vice versa. I'm itching to go, but Troy's keeping me in my position, making sure that I follow the plan and stay in maintenance. So the teamwork is, you guys know that's how we work anyway, but Fee's 10 days out now, so the posing rounds, especially after training, especially after a big leg session, this is still, we've kept the intensity high, we haven't started tapering down yet, so energy is super low, and the last thing you want to do is come and stand there doing poses, but it's super important, as you guys know, from Troy's show, where we didn't do any posing, and he suffered there, from my first show, where we did enough posing, but not enough actual posing management in the sense of tweaks to poses and whatnot. And then obviously the finals, we got it all on points and now it's perfect because the whole learning curve and learning process of the year in terms of competing, we can all put into Theo in these next 2 shows. So, you know, we're constantly improving as a collective and individually, but fatigue's very high, energy's very low, so we're just doing 2 rounds. Yesterday we did 6 seconds per pose, holding it nice and tight. Today we're doing 7 seconds, 2 minute rest in between, we're gonna go again, and like I said, pack him up, send him home, back in tomorrow to do it all over again, man. So we're at a good point at the moment, everyone's flying. Obviously, Troy's living large, as we say, episode 1, and he's already flying, so it's gonna be, we were speaking about it this morning, and I mean, the good thing with the bodybuilding sort of thing at the moment, we pick each other's brains about what we're actually feeling and where we wanna go with it, and how we're feeling in terms of the phase that we're in. And I was saying to Troy this morning, you know, how are you actually in the phase that you're in now? And like I said, he's the biggest, heaviest, leanest, strongest he's ever been. And we literally only just come out of the recovery phase ever. We're only a few weeks into the off, 3 or 4 weeks into the actual off season, which is something Troy will touch on later about the actual recovery phase and your off season phase, because a lot of people think that week after the show, when you put 10 pounds on, you're off season, and it's not the case at all. We're a couple of months post show, but a lot of that was spent in recovery for Troy. But that's the reason he's excelling so well now, why his digestion's on point well, why he's eating more than he's ever done and digesting more than he's ever been able to, and being more consistent than he ever has been. So it's all part of the process. We're all in different parts of it, but we're all moving in the same direction. So we're everything's going well. So last round for Theo, and then we'll wrap it up here, get back home, hand it back to Troy.
Look up in my eyes, so she said it picks me before they hit the ground. All night we run them numbers on a fitness app. This a cricket match, couple day affair with your wife. You think she leave it with my hoodie, bitch, give it back. Stop off at the hometown, looking like I'm still the man. I see some epitones of what it's like to finish last. Tell me what it's like.
Right, Right, so training done for the day, clients done for the day. We've got a few face-to-face check-ins and updates, which we do, and another meeting with a guy later. But first of all, it's time to go through a little bit of food with you guys. So I'm just popping down all my food for the day in my fitness pal. I'll show you guys after. We're going to go through one of the meals as well. But funnily enough, we didn't actually have any rice in the house, so I'm at Sainsbury's, and for most of you guys who've been following me as well, you'll probably see I always get the VT rices, which are the best rices around. So I'm going to clear the rack of however many rices they've got here. I'm going to get the dog some bones, then we're going to get back and make some food. So we're at Sainsbury's. This is the closest place to me. Probably not my favourite place to shop, not going to lie. I think Aldi's the best for what you actually spend for a week. So yeah, we're here at Sainsbury's. Going to get some rice, and then we'll get back and make meal one. It's meal three actually. I only have five meals for the day, so I'll show you guys what meal three is, and then we'll go from there. Got the goods. Car didn't open. Basically, we cleared the rail of rice. I'm currently just putting in my my macros for the day. So I don't know if you can actually see this right now. That's like, my target is 675 carbs, 80 fat, 220 protein. And that's with, at the moment, we've put in one intra workout, two, three, four meals. And funnily enough, for those who don't believe me, I've actually got a cheese and smoked ham sandwich from Sainsbury's, two packs of Snacker Jacks, a pack of Sun Bites, apple juice and pineapple. That's my post-workout meal right now, which is going down a treat. But yeah, like I said, I'll go through all this in detail once I've filled it in exactly. And I'm going to try and work in a McDonald's into this plan today. So for all you guys who followed our last series, no, our old series when we used to have a Mackey's a day, I'm not going to advise it to everyone, but you know, if it fits into your macros and all that, it works. So yeah, let's get back home. Let's make some food and let's crack on with this video. Car won't start. Yeah, so I've got a ghost on my car, so if you don't put the code in right, the car's not starting. Here we go, mate.
Might have a Porsche, but you're still stalling.
Yeah, might have a Porsche, can't open the doors, can't start the car, tore my quad on the first video. What a way to start the series, man.
Not exactly bigger and better, is it? Come on.
It's no bigger and better, but it's living large. Living fucking large, mate. So we have the wonderful and most will say my better half. So yeah, Chelsea's prepping the meals. I don't know, I don't know how people do prep on their own. I'm not gonna lie, Chelsea's got me through fucking so much prepping food and everything for all of my preps. So, big shout out to Chel Chel. We are just making, this is meal four now, and I've literally just worked out my macros for the day with my ham sandwich in, which I told you guys about, and with, I'm just adding in two plates, so that's two. So, six of them. So I probably just need to bring protein down a little bit, but yeah. So like I said, I've been chatting with Scott about it as well. The last couple of days I've been kind of going off a macro-based diet. Joe allows me to have set macros as long as I kind of fit that. Now and again, I'll just send him over my food intake, which at the moment is 675 gram of carbs, 80 gram of fat, and 220 protein, which is doable, but from clean food, it's quite hard, it's quite boring, and I'm all for doing things you enjoy. Yes, we kind of eat for purpose at the end of the day, but if it fits within my macros right now, and Joe's happy with it, bear in mind, I haven't actually asked Joe that this week, so I'll probably put that in the video next week if he tells me to sort my food out even more, but I'm going to show you guys how we've actually set it up. So bear in mind, my target is 675 carbs, 80 fat, 220 protein, and this is our current setup. We've got 682, so over on our carb intake by 7 gram, 82 gram of fat, so we're over in 2 gram of fat, and then 220, so 17 gram of protein over. So I'll probably just bring down my
way, which I can do right now. So let's do that, bring this right down. And it's what I like to do with a lot of clients, especially in the off season, or a lot of lifestyle clients. Me and Scott, we will always give you a set diet plan, but if not, and that doesn't work well for you, which we always like to give a set diet plan to start with to regain a certain amount of structure, which I think is very important. But once you build a relationship with a client and they have an understanding that, you know, they're not going to go over on their macros, macro target can work for people. So, like I said, it builds your knowledge on what's in certain foods, and it gives you a lot more flexibility. Even though our diet plans, we give all our clients so much flexibility with different carb sources, protein sources, having a macro set diet gives you, you know, the most flexibility possible. So let's bring that down to 50 and let's see where we're at. 228, you can bring it out a little bit more. That's a 40. There we go, literally bang on my macros now. And then for anyone at home, that's, remember, my intake is 675, so we're just on that. 80 fat, I'm on 82, and my protein is 220, I'm on 219, so that is pretty much bang on. And this is my breakthrough, my diet. Hopefully I can get a little screenshot of these meals and just pop them on the screen, like in and around my head now. That'd be perfect if you could do that, Dan. But meal one, we got 6 pancakes.
Is
that the door?
Yeah.
We've got client check-ins face-to-face here today as well, so
go for that in a minute.
So meal one, breakfast, is 6 Scottish pancakes, 60 gram of ISO whey, 150 gram of blueberries, and 150 ml of orange juice with all my AM supplements. Then we train around 10, 11. So we have 100 gram of cyclic dextrin, which is like an intra-carb drink for those who don't know. Meal three, this is my post-workout meal, probably my most favorite meal. Cheese and ham sandwich from Sainsbury's, 2 pack of Snacker Jacks, pack of Sunbikes, orange juice, no, apple juice this time, and pineapple. Now we're onto this meal, which my beautiful partner is cooking right now. We've got 150 gram of chicken. In this off-season phase, like I said, we're adding seasonings, we're adding a little bit of sauce. I'm not really too fussed about that. I'm not really watching it. I'm here to enjoy my food and be productive at the same time. So we've got, what sauce we got today? This sauce is banging. It's probably got a shitload of calories in, but.
Is this in my fitness pal?
No, I don't put this in my fitness pal, I'm not gonna lie. Let's actually see what's actually in it. So we've got hoisin and garlic stir fry. Let me see what's in it. Sorry. So per 100 gram, how much is the pack? 120. So we'll not use a whole pack, we'll use like half a pack. So there's about 15 gram of carbs in there for the pack, that's it. So nothing too crazy, but that is the one, hoisin and garlic. Got that from Sainsbury's. We bought a few others, so we'll trial them out over the next couple of weeks, but that's the one right now. So 150 gram of chicken for this meal. We've got mushrooms, peppers, and tomatoes, which are gonna go on the pan or the grill, and then with this rice as well. VT rice, I put it on my story all the time. Sticky rice is the one, it's so fire, and we've bought about, just bought 9, I think, from the shop. Probably see a full stack of them. But again, perfect for dieting, perfect on the go. Pretty much all my food, as you've seen, is on the go. I can take my pancakes with me on the morning when I go to the gym. I have my cyclic dextrin when I train. I get my post-workout meal from the shop. Come home, spend a little bit of time with my loved ones and the dogs. And then rest of the meals can be on the go. But yeah, this is meal 4. And then we've got 2 more meals to go this evening. And we've actually also worked in to that. Believe it or not, the last meal of the day is a double cheeseburger and a large strawberry milkshake. We have got cream of rice in there for you cream of rice fans. We've always got to keep it in there. It's such an easy meal to have, but yeah. So we've got this meal, cream of rice meal, and a cheeseburger and a milkshake. And if you don't believe me, like I said, it's already worked into my macros. That is the target. That has what been set. And that's what we do. Bearing in mind, I won't probably have that McDonald's every day, but it's just something easy, it's enjoyable. But like I said, I normally work out different meals and schedule them into my program, but that's just showing you guys at home, I can get my fucking post-workout meal from Sainsbury's, a sandwich, and my last meal of the day is a McDonald's. Not always recommended for everyone, but like I said, it's been working for me the last couple of days or so. So we're going to structure that in. We're going to get this meal in. We've got the wonderful Faye, who is here as well, who probably most of you guys have seen her journey as well. We're doing a face-to-face check-in with Faye because she lives local. Something else we offer to a lot of our online clients as well, face-to-face check-ins if you're local. It's always good to, you know, have that one-to-one response and see a client in the flesh as well. So we're going to do her check-in. Yeah, monthly check-in's done for the day. We've got another meeting with something very special. We're basically looking into like some form of an app. But like I said, we've got a meeting with him, and then we're going to take the dogs for the walk. So yeah, meal four, let's go. Pulling back on training, you're not burning as many calories, your body's not going to crave as much food, you're not going to have that urge to want to eat other things, you'll be more regimented with the program. If we literally stick to what we need to do, everything won't be an issue as much. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So when you're training harder right now, coming back up, like even with Scott, coming back off the back end of prep, if you're going full out, you're burning more calories, metabolism's going to speed up even more, you're going to be even more hungry, you're going to end up having more food off plan.
Yeah, I didn't think about
that's
that.
What you're more risk to.
That makes
whereas
sense.
Scott is a prime example. Me, obviously slightly different. I just went completely AWOL with it, but I'm paying for it and I've had to spend that time now regaining and getting the weight back off, getting back in a healthy routine, which could have saved me a couple of weeks. That's where we're at with you. One, it's okay to have something off plan. Two, the goalposts have changed now. You're not focusing on your photos and saying, right, I need to get lean here. You're focusing on, right, this needs to grow. Is this slightly bigger? Is that, you know, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
The whole goalposts have changed, and that's what we need to transition into now, from into this off-season phase with you.
And same with the training as well. I know you find it hard to not go hard, but the training,
I think what makes it hard to like not go hard is because last time I went straight in, I was still weak as fuck.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
I was going in like the same as I was on peak week.
Yeah.
And I couldn't like lift half as much that I was.
Yeah, but now
whereas this time obviously I had the week off. And strength.
But you got,
like,
I think in terms of your food as well, in terms of training volume, when we get into the off season, your food's gonna directly correlate with your training volume. So we wanna be upping your food as we up volume in terms of training. So that works together. So if you're going in 100% training now, one, you're still gonna have fatigue from training, you're gonna have diet fatigue from prep, you're gonna have general fatigue from prep in general. If you go in 100% training, then we're never going to get to that point where training and food are at the same point and we can keep increasing.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? You're just going to be fighting fatigue, and we don't want to do that. We don't want to get to the point where you burn out six weeks, 8 weeks into the off season.
Yeah.
We want to be slowly up in intensity, slowly up in volume as we up food. That way you're creating a demand for the food, then you're putting the food in and you're growing, but without getting fat or getting too fat. So. No, you're in a good position now. Bear in mind, it's Thursday. It's fucking 10 days, 12 days push up.
Feels like so long.
I know. I thought the same, but it's 12
like...
days. So you're not nowhere near recovery. Like I said, you've got diet fatigue, you've got stress fatigue, all these things that are going on with your body. So you've got to pull training back. Like literally 50%. It should be boring. Like literally, it should be boring to be in the gym. Like I'm just standing around. I did an extra set. I'm being a hypocrite myself because I did an extra set just because I felt like I was doing fuck all. But that's gonna maximise your off season. And obviously, if you wanna do next year and do multiple shows and win multiple shows, like we're gonna do, it starts from now. Do you know what I mean? So, we're in a good position.
Right, people, so as you just seen then, a little face-to-face check-in with Faye. I spoke about earlier, something that we like to offer clients who are local or, you know, just in the area or whatnot. It's always good to kind of see clients in the flesh, go for any questions and queries, and just have that kind of one-to-one personal approach towards our clients. And as you've seen then, and I'm sure plenty of you have followed Faye's journey, it's probably one of the biggest transformations we've ever produced at Swinch. So it's like, it's motivating for everyone. And now coming off the back end of prep, and you'll obviously see from Scott as well, it's probably just as important as the prep is how to approach post-show protocol and things like that. So just going through the basics of how we're going to approach our off-season and the improvements that need to be made over the next... Wait, when's she competing next? Is it going to be 2023?
Next year.
Yeah.
Like May, June next year. She's going to do earlier show.
So we haven't got time to waste, and We want to maximise every single aspect of it. So, like I said, back end of the show, literally we had the plan in place already to move forward. So, yeah, just a little insight to our one-to-one clients. Now, obviously it's Thursday. As you guys know, we do check-ins on Fridays for all our for all our six-week challenge clients. And Thursday has now become our monthly check-in days where myself and Scott sit down. We'll go through each and every monthly client. Difference between our obviously 6 week and our monthly clients, obviously the one-to-one monthly clients have a little bit more of a one-to-one approach. They get priority check-ins. We go into a little bit more of a depth approach towards maybe like sleep, recovery, different aspects of fitness and stuff like that. So yeah, Thursdays is our one-to-one clients, and then me and Scott have a little kind of recap for the week. We thought it's very important now. Scott's done his prep. We kind of invest a lot more time in towards our business and planning and preparing different things. So we sit down, kind of plan out a couple of weeks in advance and whatnot needs to be done over the weekend or etc. Once our clients are done, and then get ourselves all set up ready for tomorrow where we'll go for our 6 week challenge. So we're just gonna finish off some monthly clients, and then we're gonna, like I said, prep and plan for the week ahead. But yeah, I hope you guys have kind of enjoyed this video, a little bit of a brief insight to what's going on. As I said at the start, bodybuilding, lifestyle, the bulking phase, whatever you wanna call it, improvement phase. We've got so much we're gonna be filming over the next 18 months in total. As I said, this is gonna be my kind of off-season phase, improvement phase, like I said, whatever you wanna call it. But yeah, there's gonna be so much to do. And like I said at the start, guys, if there's anything you guys want to see specifically, make sure you know you drop it in the comments box below. Anyone you want to see us kind of link up with, or any kind of specific videos. As I said at the start, there'll be kind of no holds barred to what we'll be putting on here. Every aspect of life, every aspect of bodybuilding, all under one roof. So yeah, Living Large episode 1, guys. I hope you all enjoyed it. As always, comment, share, subscribe. We'll see you in the next video.